I'm Jeff Rubenstein from the PlayStation blog, back on the show floor. Here we are in the Tecmo booth, where there's a couple of PS3 exclusives we're going to be looking at during the show. First of all, here's a game that you've been wanting to hear a lot about, and that is Quantum. Unfortunately, Peter Gartz from Tecmo is here to tell us all about it. Now, at first blush, it's a third-person shooter. It has very Gears of War-ish overtones, but then when you look a little deeper, it seems that there's a lot more going on.
Yeah, we get that a lot. Yes, it is a sci-fi third-person shooter. We do have a big guy for a main character, but yeah, we are trying to add sort of an action element in it that, you know, is something that Tecmo can do. We know action games, so we're trying to bring some of that know-how into the third-person shooters.
Now, watching the trailer, I'm noticing some interaction between the main character and a woman with a sword.
Right. So the main character is a guy named Sid, and he is in this come to this like living tower in order to destroy it. Partway through the story, you meet up with the lady named Felena, and she has sort of her own reasons for being where she is, and sometimes you'll work together, sometimes you'll work separately, but when she's with you, yeah, you can get some sort of combination actions going. For example, if you have an opponent that's really far away, you can actually grab Felena and throw her at the opponent, and she has a really strong like sword that she can cut them with, or if you throw her above the enemies, she can throw down like a stun grenade and stun an area of enemies that you can run in and cause havoc after that. And there's some other aspects of sort of combination melee attacks that we're trying to work in as well. So we really want to bring sort of that action and sort of a cooperative feel to the game.
Okay, speaking of cooperative, what kind of multiplayer options are you looking at this time?
Well, the main story is a single player only. So offline is single player only. Most of the time when you're with Felena, she'll be controlled by the her own AI. But you can do the kind of actions on your own for like throwing her and stuff like that. That's your control. Online, we're looking at a couple of modes for like a battle royale, deathmatch, and team battles. And actually, in the team battles, you play as a female character, and she's the team leader. So one person will be the female, and the rest are the guys, and they have to sort of protect her while trying to take out the other team's leader. If the leader falls, then that team loses.
We have a bunch of guys following a girl. It sounds kind of like E3. So let's talk a little bit more about the core shooting mechanics here. They look pretty solid. The weapons seem to have some heft, so let's talk about them.
Sure. We're trying to get a good range of weapons in there. The character's default weapon is like a blaster. So he's got, she's a one-handed, kind of carried around, but it should have some weight to it. We have shotguns, we have machine guns, but we're also trying to add in a couple of like different kinds of weapons that reflect. And do some things that you might not expect.
There's sort of a, and I don't know if the word's exactly correct, but maybe like a gothic feel I'm kind of feeling by looking at it. Does that tie in with the story at all? And what can you tell us about the story?
Sure. Well, it definitely does tie in. So the story takes place in a world that's been sort of, civilization has collapsed. And these towers have cropped up around the world. And the main character, Sid, is going to these towers and taking them down. Now, the story for the game itself revolves around this one particular tower that Sid enters, and sort of his reasons for taking the towers down and the reason for the tower's existence become clear within the course of the story. So you'll see in the places where the humans made, that civilization is sort of, you know, like collapsed, you'll see more, you know, collapsed buildings and stuff you might normally think of, subway systems and things like that. But once you get into the tower, you see a more organic feel. And it's something really that we're going for because the tower is alive. The influence is really a strong influence from Art Nouveau and sort of these flowing designs and something that's organic because the tower is alive. And as you progress in the tower, you'll see it actually start to change. There's a phenomenon that actually starts to mutate the tower. And it'll become more, you might say more gothic, more grotesque, and more spiky and, you know, frightening, that kind of thing.
It sounds very interesting, and this PS3 exclusive is something that I know our readers are going to be looking forward to. When might they be able to get their hands on it?
We're looking for this as an early 2010 title.